princes to bow their knee in Saudi Arabia and declare that I am their Lord? Could it be that I can reunite Korea as one? Could it be? Could it be? Could I release the move of God throughout the nations? Could it be? What is it that you're believing me for? What is it that you need in your city? What is it that you need in your nation? For I will do it, says the Lord. I will release it, says the Lord. If only you will worship me. If only you will lift your voices to me. For I will fill stadiums. People will say, is it true? Is it true? There's a move of God in Texas. Is it true? There's a move of God in Colombia. Is it true? There's a move of God in the UK. Is it true? There's a move of God in Asia. For I'm breaking out, says the Lord. I am moving in your midst. If only you will worship me. For the key, says the Lord, is if you will unite your hearts in worship. I will fill stadiums. I will release a move of my spirit. I will release glory like you've never known, declares the Spirit of the Lord. And there shall be a release, even in this hour, from the future generations to know the voice of healing. Could it be another healing move? Could it be? Yes, says the Spirit of the Lord. He can, and it will, and it is happening even now. Release your voice.
Out of Exodus chapter 8, and this was a scripture that meant a lot to me. One day when I was pastoring in Arizona, you know, you have to water your lawn at night because it's so hot in the day that it scorches. And I remember one night walking out to turn off the faucet, and I was barefoot, and I thought, oh, the ground feels so funny underneath my feet. And then I thought, oh, what is that? There must be a lot of mosquitoes out tonight. Now, this is a prophetic word that I'm giving you. And so, but I thought, I've never felt the ground like this. But when I turned off the faucet and I turned back around, the light of my front porch showed me that the ground was actually covered with frogs and that they were bouncing all over my legs. And the worst part of it, I was 9 months pregnant. And as you can tell, I'm not very tall. So I was as wide as I am tall right now. And so I remember standing there and just going, ah, you know, what do I do? And have you ever watched a pregnant lady run? You know, I ran like that all the way back acre across the front pastures to get to the house. But the scripture that the Lord gave me this morning, this is what it said. It says that Moses went to Pharaoh and said, okay, now I'm going to have Joshua go stretch his rod across the waters, and the frogs are going to come out. And he says, the frogs are going to be in your oven. They're going to be in your bread bowl. The frogs are going to be in your bedchamber. The frogs are going to be in your shower. He says the frogs are going to jump be in your servant's house. It says the frogs are going to be in your house, and the frogs are going to be on your body. Can everybody just give me one of those? And so after a few days of the frogs being everywhere, it says Pharaoh summoned Moses. And he says, okay, tell your God to get rid of the frogs. And listen to what Moses said, because I believe this is a prophetic word for this tonight. Moses said, when do you want my God to take away this torment? When do you want him to shift your land? When do you want the frogs out of your life removed? I'm putting the time right in your now. Hand, Pharaoh. When do you want it to take place?
Right now.
And right Pharaoh now. Said, tell your God tomorrow. Look at somebody and say, what was wrong with that man?
What was wrong with him?
No, we want the frogs dealt with right now. The right now, tonight.